In the previous video, we looked at how to create animation using various methods using the interface and sliders. Now let's move on to the next example, where we will look at more animated channels as well as the animation editor. To the left of the screen, you will find an animation button. Clicking on this button brings up the animation editor. The animation editor can be displayed in three ways, and you'll see similarities to what you may have been used to in other applications. The first view is the channel editor that shows the animation on a curve. Here you can adjust keyframes on the curve to control the speed of the animation per channel. The second view is the tracks editor that allows you to see the timings of your animation on each channel. Like in other applications, you can stretch the animation, or you can click and drag keyframes to adjust the timings within the animation. The third and final view is the info view. This view displays your animation in a spreadsheet view that can be used to see values without sifting through curves or tracks. This view can also assist if you do any animation with expressions. An expression uses math and logic to automate animation, but we will not cover expressions in this lesson. Returning to the channel view, you will see to the left of the channel editors are all the animation channels arranged in a tree structure. This means you can twirl the triangles to reveal the particular animation channels. When a channel with animation is opened through the hierarchy, its animation curve is revealed. If you want to hide a particular curve, you simply close the channel. The animation curve shows your keyframes and animation generated by the curve. To see the whole curve in the channel view, press the frame button to frame the selected curve. Or press the frame all to frame every exposed curve in the curve editor. Ascending and descending curves show changes in animation value. A flat curve normally means there is no change in a value at that point in time. Just so that you know, a white curve is a selected curve and a black curve is not selected. To select a channel, you can simply click on the channel in the list, or you could click the curve. You could also use Command Click to add to the selection. You also have the ability to focus directly on keyframes. You use Command Click to select or deselect keyframes on a curve or multiple curves. And you can also hold Command and drag a box selection around a region of keyframes to select them. Once the keyframes are selected, you can move them around simply by dragging them in the channel view. As an extra tip, you can hold Shift Command and drag another selection box to add or subtract from the existing selection. To copy and paste a channel or keyframes, ensure they are selected, press Copy, and choose the destination channel and press Paste. If the positioner is at a different point in time and you paste selected keyframes and not a selected channel, the keyframes will be pasted from the start of the positioner, causing an animation offset. In the Tools pull-down menu, you can change the cursor modes for working in the animation editor. Select or Shift M is your general select and move mode. Choose Add Points or Shift A, and you can click on an animation curve to add additional keyframes. Or you can choose Delete from the pull-down menu or press Shift D to be able to delete keyframes by clicking on them on the curve. One other cursor I would like to point out is Break Tangents. This is assigned to Shift B. This cursor allows you to break the symmetrical tangents so that you can adjust the curve independently on either side of the keyframe. You now need to use the Select mode to move the tangents. If you want to lock the tangents together again, switch back to the Break Tangents mode and click on the keyframe. The next time you click on the tangent handle, the opposing handle will snap back into alignment. So you can choose which tangent handle will snap into place. The last two modes I want to show you for now is the Y scale and X scale. Use the Tools pull-down menu or press Shift Y to enable the mode. This mode allows you to scale the animation vertically. This means that the animation is larger and is amplified over a greater range of values. Click and drag on a selected channel or bunch of selected keyframes, and by dragging up and down, you scale the curve from the point where you click and drag. Finally, in the Tools pull-down menu, choose X Scale or press Shift X. This mode scales the curve sideways that exponentially increases and decreases the timing of the animation. There are other modes that will be covered in a future video. If you prefer a more traditional approach to working with keyframes, you can use the classic button menus to the right of the screen. You can set keyframes or you can delete selected keyframes. You also have a reset button to reset selected channels. To adjust a keyframe to a specific value, navigate to the keyframe with the navigation controls. In the channel list, click once on the value and type the new value into the calculator. Pressing Enter will confirm the new value and the curve will change. So setting values for keyframes positions them to create an animation curve. But looking at the actual curve between the keyframes, you can also choose the curve interpolation or what some other software might call smoothing. To the right of the channel view, you can change the interpolation. There are a few to choose from, and familiar modes such as Bezier, Linear, and Constant should cover most of the curves you are after. To adjust the smoothing on a keyframe, make sure you select the keyframe first using Command Click. And then change the interpolation. If you want the entire channel to change, then select the entire channel and change the interpolation mode. The final option I'm going to show you is the extrapolation. After the animation has been completed between keyframes, you can decide to loop the animation beyond its initial length. You can select different repeat modes, such as cycle and reverse cycle. Just so that you're aware, there are quite a few other animation tools such as math operations, audio-generated animations, filtering, and expressions. Feel free to discover these tools by yourself. In the next video, we'll look at how to deal with mixing different resolutions in the sequence with the resized timeline effects.